Today we are going to paint on a tray that I purchased at a Goodwill store. And we're going to do hydrangeas and daisies. This is just the beginning, just laying down some color. And this is one of my favorite things to paint. I start with a dark color. Over here is a dark ultramarine blue. And I just put down that dark color to get it started, to have a base. I'm shaping it, just trying to see what it is I'm gonna like here. Just adding more paint and no particular pattern. I'm not really making a particular pattern or anything. I'm just shaping. Now I'm gonna add a little bit of a lighter color. I've added some white to the dioxazon purple that I had there, and I'm just in random strokes bringing it forward. Again, this is really just an underlayment. It's not really the flowers. It's an impression of the flowers. This is sort of impressionistic. I do go around in kind of I don't know, a loopy kind of thing there, curved. But again, I'm not really painting the petals. I'm going to start adding a few leaves in here. I'm using a much bigger brush. And hydrangea leaves have kind of a rough edge, so I'm trying to give them that rough edge as I create them. And yes, I'm going to paint over some of the flowers to put the leaves and the stems and the other flowers over top. I'm kind of roughing out that edge there. Here goes another big leaf. I try to keep my hand out of the way of the camera, but sometimes I forget and I can't help it. Going to throw in a few stems here. That first one was almost too straight, but it'll work its way out as we add some leaves to it. This is just a smaller leaf. The same as the big ones, just a little smaller. I'm using the same brush. So here you're gonna lose the fact that that stem was really very straight, and I'm gonna accentuate it by adding a real big curve there in that leaf. You have to learn to move your brush in different directions. There's several edges on every brush. I'm putting some more rough edges on that hydrangea leaf. So you have to play with the brush and the paint to figure out exactly what kind of movement creates what kind of mark. And I'm putting some, I'm flipping a few of the leaves. So you're looking at the underside. That one leaf was not connected to anything. So I gave it a stem, giving this one a stem, and it's going over top of part of that purple hydrangea. Here comes the support stems to hold those big heads up. Well, this was really hard to keep my hand out of the way. I don't want to say they're random, but you don't want a pattern. And I almost had a pattern there under that purple one, so I added another one. On that blue one, I can't seem to keep my hand out of the way. Now I'm going to start actually forming some petals now to give it more of a hydrangea look and feel. And this is just with lighter colored paint. As I bring them forward, they get lighter and lighter. I could add some of the blue or some of that turquoise to any of the hydrangeas because they have such a variegated color in them. I make a few of the petals of the florets to actually look like a floret with four or so small petals connecting. But I don't do too many, just a couple. I might connect two or three petals as a floret, but I'm just giving the impression again that this is hydrangea and it's hydrangea petals. I'm gonna work over here on this blue one. That one's the closest to the camera, so it kind of, my hand kind of gets in the way, but I think you can see what I'm doing there. Again, I'm just sort of forming a few florets to look like the flower. I come back in later with the very end of my brush and put some white dots in the center of those florets. I don't think that's going to show on this video, but it really changes the whole look of the hydrangea. So you want to make sure you remember to do that at the end of your flower. This is one of my favorite things to paint is hydrangeas and daisies. And when I went to the thrift store, I saw some trays, some wooden ones, some plastic ones, some wicker ones, and I'm going to be painting them in the future. They're just a lot of fun. You could hang them on the wall. You can use them as a tray. I'm also at the end, you won't see this either, but I'm going to give it several coats of a clear acrylic finish varnish. Here I'm just kind of looking around to see what needs better shape, what needs better color. Also, remember to step back and give it a look because a painting is meant to be viewed at 6 feet. Even if it's on a tray, you might not see where the corrections need to be made. Okay, now I'm gonna start adding some daisies. I got that one up there in the left-hand corner. You know, I have a whole playlist of hydrangea paintings because I love to paint them. And I'll put that up in the corner or the description or someplace. I'm going to put the center in here. Just going to kind of shape him up a little bit. Now I'm going to bring some more petals into it. I like having a light color. It gives it kind of a lacy look. Here's one more daisy up here. I don't start from left and go to right. I go left, right, left, right. I work my way around, so it is relatively evenly spaced. Okay, all that one over there is dry, so I'm gonna add a few more shorter petals on the outside edge there. Bringing those back into the center. Now I'm going to kind of clean up that center part. And there we have it. I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks so much for watching. Okay, so I've got 9.